Hey guys, in this video, I'll show you how to create a Shopify product feed so that you can import and update all of your products on Shopify. The feed I'm going to show you is super quick to make. And at the end of this video, I'll show you a few tricks that you can do with this feed, like how to automatically resize all of the images on your Shopify catalog that can save you a lot of manual work. So you might want to hit that save button so you can come back to this video later on. And of course, subscribe to this channel because we're always coming out with videos on tips and tricks to help you manage your product catalog and other e-commerce related topics. All right, to create this feed, we're going to use Plitix PIM. I've left the link to it in the description of this video. I've also left some resources in case you want to learn more about Plitix and all of the features that it has to help you manage your product information more efficiently. So we're going to use Plitix's channels feature here and click on add channel. As you can see, there are a few options to choose from. So you can even use this to create a feed for Google Shopping, or if you need to create feeds for specific customers or other channels that you sell on, you can choose these options here. But of course, we're looking to create a Shopify channel. When you click on Shopify, you'll see the option to connect to an existing store or a new connection. Basically, what this means is if you've already connected Plitix to your Shopify store before, then you can choose the existing store option. Or if you haven't done that yet, or you want to connect to a different store, you can just click on new connection. I already have my store connected, so I'm just going to choose the existing store option. To add a new connection, just click on that and follow the steps laid out. Or if you want me to make a video on that, just let me know in the comments. Or you can also check out the Help Center article that explains it all, which I'll also link in the description. Once you've created the channel, you'll be taken to this page here with all of these tabs. Now, if you're in a hurry and you want the quick version, I'll show you that in just a second. But if you want to know all the cool details that will save you time when creating feeds, stick with me. All right. The quick version. The mappings tab here contains a template with the Shopify fields that you need or can include in your feed. To the left, you have the attributes or information that you match to these Shopify fields. Then in the products tab, you can select which products you want to include in this feed. In the settings tab, you can schedule this feed to be imported into Shopify on a set schedule if you want to automate it, or you can click on process now to import the feed into Shopify right away. That was the quick version. But now I'm going to show you why this is better than just creating a normal feed in a spreadsheet or some other tool. Let's go back to the mappings tab. In the Shopify fields column, you already have all of the fields that Shopify allows you to import via a CSV import. So like handle, title, body would each be a column in a traditional spreadsheet. All you have to do is match these with the attributes that you have in Plitix like this. Now let's look at the title. This is gonna be the title of your product listing, right? Let's say that your titles need to include the brand name and the product name. If you have those two pieces of information in two separate attributes, you don't need to manually combine that or anything. You can just create what in Plitix is known as computed attributes, which in essence is a formula that will do the work for you. So as an example, here I want my product title to include brand and label. So I'll create this formula that combines those two attributes to create my new name. Another cool thing about this feed template is that it separates your parent and your variant attributes to make it easier to tell them apart and fill them in. So like here for parent fields, I have option one name. And then under variant fields, I have option one value, which as you know, is how we add variations to our products in Shopify. Now, if you noticed when I was scrolling through this earlier, there are fields for image gallery and featured image. That's because we can also use this feed to send images to Shopify. You just match it to the media attribute that you have in Plitix, and you can even resize, transform, or rename your images on export, which I'll show you in just a bit. But first, let's head on over to the products tab. By the way, if you're liking this video so far, please give it a thumbs up. It'll help this video reach more people, but most importantly, it'll let me know that these videos are helpful for you, so I'll know to keep making them. So we've chosen the attributes that we want to send over to Shopify. So again, in a traditional spreadsheet, this would be the columns. Now we need to choose which products we want to send that information for, right? So the rows. Here, you can either choose an existing list of products or create a new list. What does this mean? Well, you can create a list of products that you want to work with based on filters and conditions. So let's say you want this feed to update all of your Shopify products. You can create a list of all your products. Or let's say that you have multiple stores and this specific feed should only update the ones in store A. You can create a list of only products in store A. Or let's say that you only want to update products from store A that are less than $100. You can do that too. What's special about this is that once you save your list, you can edit it, of course, but you can also use it across multiple feeds and other features within Plitix. You just tell it, hey, send this information there. And instead of you having to copy all of that information for the selected products over to a new spreadsheet and add products, remove products, add columns, remove columns, you just choose the list, choose the attributes, and Plitix will do the work of copying all that data over and formatting it how you want. Speaking of formatting, let's go back and talk about image transformations. Say that you notice your product images are slowing down your web store or whatever the case may be, and you want to resize your images. Rather than having to have your designer re-export them all or create duplicates of your images, you can do it straight from this feed. Just hover over the media field, click on this button here, click resize, and choose the new dimensions. You can also do some other transformations like change your image format, rename files according to specific rules or attributes, which is good for SEO and meta tags, and you can even combine different media attributes to create your product gallery. Now, the best part about this feed, and I might have mentioned this a little bit earlier, but it needs emphasizing, is that once you've set it up, meaning once you've set up the headers and selected the product list, Plitix will keep that information up to date with the latest data that you have. So, say you have 10 different feeds and you need to update the values for some of your products in each of those feeds, instead of having to go through each feed yourself and making those changes manually, you only need to update it once. And Plitix will make sure that the data is accurate and up to date across all of those feeds, which is why having a central source of truth for your product information is so useful. Anyway, that's how you create a Shopify feed in Plitix. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. And if you want to try Plitix and get started creating your own feeds, check out the link in the description. And of course, don't forget to like this video, subscribe to this channel, and hit that notification button so you never miss a new video. See you next time. Just hover. You can create...